morning, treasurers. This is your host, Parthesh, co-founder of Night Fintech, and you are listening to Night Snippets. Here is all what you need to know before going into trade for 8th April 2021. In the international market, the FOMC's March meetings showed that participants were seeing signs of an economic rebound and a pickup in inflation, but still believed there is a long way from altering their interest rate policy or asset purchase program. Following the FOMC minutes, US bond yields are consolidating. US 10-year closed at 168 and 30-year closed at 2.32 percentage points on Wednesday. In the crude oil market, crude is trading at $62.72 per barrel. Short-term range seems to be $61 to $65 per barrel. In the currency market, dollar index or DXY is at 92.43. Today's range for DXY seems to be 92.25 to 92.76. USD CNY or Chinese Yuan is at 6.55, trading stable. USD INR with a low of 73.52 closed at 74.47. USD INR's range for today seems to be 74.20 to 74.50. Now here are the reasons for the drastic move. Reason number one. The Indian Central Bank announced a new bond buying program called GSEP, under which it will purchase rupees 1 lakh crore in government securities via the secondary market. Some see this as a QE-like move, which would be negative for the currency. And number two, other reasons such as unwinding positions of offshore non-deliverable forward market, which is used by the foreign investors to hedge the currency risk. Essentially, this move by the central government has killed the carry trade and made traders to unwind their positions. In the domestic market, let's look at RBI's MPC policy action first today. Action number one, repo unchanged at 4% and reverse repo unchanged at 3.35. Policy stance accommodative. MPC kept its growth outlook for FY22 unchanged at 10.5%. but warned of downside risks, particularly from the second wave of COVID-19 infections. CPI projections were well below MPC's inflation targets, but acknowledges the supply side pressure on the inflation. Now, here is the interesting news for bonds. RBI announced GSEP, which is Government Security Acquisition Program, which is more like a QE in nature. Here, RBI has announced GSEP 1.0, where RBI will buy rupees 1 lakh crore in quarter 1 FY22 and has promised to do more if needed. Governor also stated that from Jan to March 2021, liquidity was abundant and rupees 4.9 lakh crore on an average were parked in reverse repo. To address this liquidity, longer 10-year variable rate reverse repo operations will be carried out. The timing and the tenure of this will depend on the liquidity conditions. Governor categorically reiterated that this should not be seen as liquidity tightening. It is just the liquidity normalization, which he has been reiterating for many days. In short, RBI showed a change in approach. There was a visible shift in the forward guidance from time-dependent to state-dependent, for transitioning from accommodative to gradual calibrated normalization. Following the news, 515 GS 2025 closed at 560 versus 557 the previous trading day. 585 GS 2030 closed at 608 versus 612 the previous trading day. Remember, we had given a scenario analysis yesterday whereby we had given a high probability on positive momentum with 6.08 on cards. RBI made it possible. Quantitative models saw it through before it came. Yesterday, public sector banks sold heavily with net sales of rupees 2,769 crores. But this was mainly absorbed by private sector banks with rupees 2,388 crores. Again, mutual fund houses bought 1,070 crores on fresh fund inflows. Now, with this extra QE or GSEP, brings a lot of confusion, a lot of questions for the investors, and there is no single solution for them. Reach out to us for your HTM AFS shifting. Again, Knight Research had deliberately taken a decision to hold back HTM AFS shifting and asked all the clients to wait until RBI policy. But now, given the GSEP, the calculations and the future changes. Now this is the time to make the change in your HTM AFS shifting portfolio with this new GSEP in place. Reach out to us for more information. That's it for today. You were listening to Night Snippets with Parthesh Shah, co-founder of Night Fintech. See you tomorrow with the new episode of Night Snippets.